become the home of the Tigers since 2000. Comerica Park here in the Motor City. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the St. Louis Cardinals and the Detroit Tigers. John Shambi along with Chris Singleton. Chris, one guy having a big year for this club, leading the team at home runs and runs batted in, Mark Canna. He leads the team and wins above replacement, so most days you can expect him to be a big factor for these guys.
Yeah, Boogie's definitely a huge piece of the puzzle for this ball club right now. He's just having a really nice year, and that's on both sides of the ball, not just offensively. You talk to guys in the clubhouse, the coaching staff, they always have great things to say about him, and they say the team really looks to him to be one of the on-field leaders day in and day out.
Just about set to go now. And on the mound today, Tarek Skubal. Base runners are tough to come by with him out there, Chris.
Well, he's been a real quality starter for his club. And coming into this one, what stands out for me is that right-handed hitters have really struggled batting below 200 on the year. It seems they have a hard time picking up his release point and tracking the ball into the zone. So we'll see how right-handers do against him in this one.
And now the count is even.
One ball, one strike.
In the air, left side. Green on the run. Flashes the leather on the running catch. And a quick out number one. Here's the Cardinals lineup now. Someone who makes things happen for them, in part with his legs, Mason Winn.
Tops on the team in batting average, Boog. A guy who's showing off some excellent bat-to-ball ability when he digs in at the plate. You know, that's useful if your team needs to get an inning going, get a leadoff man on, but it's also incredible to have a guy like that in the lineup because he's a run producer who can drive in runs if you've got guys on base already. So he's a huge piece in this lineup.
One out, base is empty. Ripped to short. And Contreras is retired.
Well, Boog, we talk about how the ball is coming out of a pitcher's hand. The way it comes out of his hand as an infielder, wow, really impressive.
Here's Nolan Arenado. First offering, and it just misses. Two outs, base is empty. Next offering is in for a strike. The wind of the pitch.
That's in, ball two.
Foul ball. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Meadows sizing this one up, and that'll do it. We'll go to the bottom of the first, 0-0. Back here in Detroit. And on the hill here today, Lance Lynn. What's the scouting report on him?
Well, he's been a very dependable starter for his club. And what stands out for me is that left-handed hitters have really struggled batting below 200 against him. And it just tells me they have a hard time tracking the baseball. Maybe it's the release point. Maybe it's the motion. But just some way, somehow, they've got to figure out a way to pick it up and try to have some success from the left side.
That's a little bit low.
One and one.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss. And one gone. Here's Mark Canna. tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. One down, base is empty.
Really good cutter that he's able to front door and back door. That pitch is devastating.
Got him. Two away.
Well, anytime you can punch out the top two guys in a lineup to start an inning, got to be feeling pretty good out there on the mound, because when you think of just having a distraction, table setters on the base paths, and all of a sudden you're dealing with the number three hitter, any distraction can cause you to serve up a cookie, and instead of it being a solo shot, it's a two or three run homer.
Two outs. Misses outside. And one and one.
Looks really sharp at the start of this one. This is how it's going to be today. It's going to be a tough one for this lineup.
Two down, nobody on. That one missed. This to third, Arenado fires over to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Tigers fail to make any noise, scoreless after one. Back at Comerica Park, top of the second. Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate.
Here's a player known for playing better in day games, which is not always the case. I mean, day games are different, Boo. Things change from game times to your daily routine, but he sure makes the transition look easy.
And that gets the top of the zone for a strike.
I'm impressed that he went right after him on that first pitch. That's the key. Try to get ahead in the count, and you can play around a little bit more as the at-bat expands.
On the inside corner for a strike.
He doesn't seem to like the pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
High chopper to third. And that's just foul. The lefty fires. Foul ball. It stays nothing and two. And a pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. And now the lefty. Up the middle, and that one finds its way through. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Now it's Ivan Herrera. And that one fouled off. The pitch.
That's a ball.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
James Kingsley, our plate umpire, consistent and maybe a little generous on the edges.
Yeah, he'll give a little bit on the edges, like you said, but from what I've seen, he usually does that when a pitcher is just commanding those parts of the strike zone. And
the kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Swing and a miss. The throw. Tag. And he's out.
Well, I think that was a hit and run right there. When you look at how far that pitch was out of the zone and the hitter still trying to put wood on it, put it in play, that tells you that they had something going. But unfortunately, there was a good job of execution by the pitcher and the catcher to get that out of the zone and then throw out the runner at second base. Really nice job behind the dish.
Base is empty, one away here at the top of the second. Wouldn't That's chase that time. Out to short, McKinstry gets it to first. That's it out.
Batting fifth, the right junior, number 21, Lars.
Now up for St. Louis, Lars Nootbaar. First pitch misses. No score here in the second. Right through there for a strike. And down on strikes. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down. 1-2-3. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And welcome back to the ballpark. We head to the bottom of the second. And the batter now, Kerry Carpenter. And the right-hander back to work. That's off the mark, and it's 1-0.
Counts 1-0.
And another ball. Good hitters count the 2-0. There's a strike.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And the righty deals. Popped up. Wynn gets under it. And there's one down.
Got it. Good. The third baseman.
And up next for Detroit, Matt Vierling. Swings through that one.
Now that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. He talked about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
That one is absolutely belted. And that gets down into the gap. Makes the turn and heads for second. Not stopping. He's going for three. And he's got himself a triple.
He was all over that one. Man, that feels so good to shoot an absolute bolt the opposite way. Split the gap and know that you've got extra bases right off the bat. That's the kind of thing hitters dream about when they're falling asleep at night. Got in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
So one gone with a runner at third. At the plate, Colt Keith. Just missed. With the go-ahead run at third, bottom half of inning number two. That's in for a strike. Pitch fights that one away, still 1-2. And a pitch that misses. Two balls, two strikes.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open
to the right side, and he grabs it in foul ground. And here comes. That one outside. And the count is filled up. Zach McKinstry to bat next. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. On the ground to third. Throws high and over his head. So up next, Zach McKinstry.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Off the plate, and that's ball one. And a good eye there. Keith leads off first with one away. That one the other way. And foul ball. Righty delivers. And now it's even up.
Two balls, two strikes.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Righty to the plate. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. And a pitch. And that's off the inside edge. 3-2 now. And a pitch. And he walked him. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
When you go that deep into an at bat, the hitter usually comes out on top.
The catcher.
So first and second with one man gone. Next to hit, Jake Rogers. That's through there for a strike. Right-hander kicks, deals.
Ball one.
That one misses. And now it's even 1-1. One out. Runners at first and second. Here comes a pitch. And that's down and away. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees.
Good pitch right there. I mean, he's attacking a location that this guy at the plate tends to have trouble with. And there's just so much information in this day and age, sometimes too much information. But the guys that can take that information, process it, and then go out there, Boog, and execute the pitch, go right after that hitter and get the result that they were anticipating, that's really good pitching right there. And it's a good job of the pitcher and the catcher working together.
And the 1-0. And a strike in there. Fastball for a strike. And it's 1-2. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Good job at damage control right there. One run in the inning, but they leave two. We played two full. It's the Tigers 1 and the Cardinals nothing. And we're back onto the third inning. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Mason Wynn. Scooble back to work. That one a little bit high. 1-0. There's a strike. Looking to get the tying run on base. And that one fouled off. Kicks and deals. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Here's Nolan Gorman. And that one hammered. That's back there. And he makes the catch on the track. Just missed a homer that time.
Outstanding catch right there. And I love the commitment that he showed. He knew that the wall was close, but was determined to make that catch. And a nice calculation of just how much room he had to try to minimize that contact.
Michael Ciani in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Now this guy is just filling up the strike zone right now. Don't want to get yourself in an 0-2 hole. You better be ready to pull a trigger on the first pitch.
Two outs. That one just misses. Now 1-2.
It's a good take.
Swings and misses. Struck him out. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They trail here 1-0. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's Riley Green.
The left fielder.
As he turns on the rubber and with that good live arm delivers. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. The wind of the pitch. Ripped towards third. One up, one down.
Now batting, first baseman, Mark Canha.
And next to hit for Detroit, Mark Canha. He was a strikeout victim his first time. A little bit low.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
One down, base is empty. That's inside.
Two strikes.
Foul ball left side. He'll see another. The other way, and it goes just foul.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Drive, and that's base hit out of the center field. So he ends up with a hit after seeing a lot of pitches. That was a good at bat.
Wow. So important to get into the fielding position after you deliver that baseball. That is a scary one. Watch your lips.
Man at first, Wenzel Perez up now for the Tigers. On the corner for a strike.
0-1.
Kicks and fires. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
We'll take a look at the three-pitch sequence here. Pretty simple in terms of putting them away at the plate. Once you're ahead 0-2 as a pitcher, you can really expand the zone and see how aggressive that hitter is going to be trying to protect and battle. And right there, clearly he was in swing mode, but all you can do is hope to foul that off.
Now it's the right fielder, Kerry Carpenter. 0-1 with a flyout. That pitch gets the inside corner. 0-1. Canna off of first with two away. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
0-2.
And that's off the inside edge. And the count is 1-2. Left-hand batter waits. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. One left for Detroit. They lead it 1-0. Back here in Detroit, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Brendan Donovan. Scoobal back to work. And ball one.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Next offering is in for a strike. The wind of the pitch. Late with the swing there.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
And another ball. The wind to kick the pitch. That one down the line, and it finds its way through for a hit. And the tying run is on with a leadoff single.
Dominant performance for him today, Boo. Just two hits allowed so far, no runs across either. And he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced. So I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
And up to hit is Wilson Contreras. That's a bullet, but it goes foul.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and hard the order coming up right behind them. This is where they need to get going.
And he deals. Swing and a high fly ball, deep left field. Green on the move, heading back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Here's Nolan Arenado. He's 0-1. Pitch misses inside. Ball one.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
And that one missing low. And a 2-1 on the way.
3 balls, 1 strike.
Well, in this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
And a 3-1 on the way. And that drops in for a strike.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
At the belt and fires. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a pitch. Lined in the left center. Should be extra bases. Makes the turn at second. Heads for third. Here comes the runner. The relay throw. It's off the mark, and he scores. It's 1-1.
Gets it done to drive in the run and tie it back up. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great. Now the go-ahead runs in scoring position, so big opportunity for them to jump ahead late.
Substitution now at second base and pinch running for St. Louis, Jose Fermin. Go-ahead run on base. And here's the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. Ripped into right center. Should be extra bases. Coming home. He will score and they take the lead. It's 2-1.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side. And the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Ivan Herrera, the next to hit. Turned on, but foul wide of third. The pitch. That misses the zone, and it's 1-1. One out, the runner at second, top half of inning number four. A little out front there as he swings through it. Inside, almost got him. The pitch. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Meadows makes the grab on the run.
Now back, right fielder, Lars Newcomb.
So two down now, and here is Lars Newcomb. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. Swing and he breaks his bat and makes the grab. And that is that. Two runs, three hits, no errors, and one left. We're midway in the fourth. It's the Cardinals 2 and the Tigers 1. Now into the ball game on defense, Jose Fermin. He's the new third baseman. Matt Veerland up now for the Tigers. One for one, he tripled in his first trip. The pitch. And that's outside. And that is ball one. Just missed.
He's clearly trying to work him away here. Both pitches off the plate. If you really want to put the ball in play, you're going to have to stay back and drive it to the opposite field.
Now 3-0. Colt Keith up next for the Tigers. Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. That one finds the zone. 3-1. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Siani makes a nice running catch.
Nothing instills more confidence in a team than a center fielder who makes a great play like that on the run. They can feed off the energy he brings just from his playmaking abilities.
Fought off foul. One down, base is empty. To the right side, Gorman. In plenty of time to first, and that's an out.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, Zach McKinstry. He reached out a walk his first time. And that's through there for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Holding on to a one-run lead. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. That's off the mark. Going to count 1-2. Got him. Picks up strikeout number 7. Tigers are shut down there, and they trail it here 2-1. Back at Comerica Park. Now it's the shortstop, Mason Wynn. The pitch. And there's a ball. Next offering is in for a strike. And here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that's strike 2.
One ball, 2 strikes.
Out to short. It's on to Canna. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Now that second baseman, Nolan Gorman.
Nolan Gorman will hit next. Ball 1 there. That's a strike, and it's 1-1.
Now, just a cement mixer slider right there. It's a great pitch to hit if you can recognize it early and jump on it.
Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2. And downstairs. One down, base is empty. Got him swinging.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Now batting Michael Ciani. Struck out swinging his first time. And that's a base hit. And that turns the lineup over.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Donovan in the box for the third time today as he takes that one off the plate. Two outs, just off the outside edge, and that's ball 2. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball 3. Ciani, the runner at first with 2 gone. Up the middle. And that one handled. Safe at second.
Well, that extra step before getting rid of it to throw to second cost him an out. He should have just gone to first at that point.
Wilson Contreras now up to the plate. That one off the mark, and it's 1-0. First and second, 2 down. That misses the zone, and the count is 2-0.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on, probably a challenge pitch coming.
2-0. Right through there for a strike. And a base hit right there. Now a long throw home. He beats the throw, and they get a run at home.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
First and second, two down. And up next for St. Louis, Jose Fermin. Two on, two outs. On the ground, right side, Canna steps on the bag. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. But they pick up one run on the RBI single, and this is now a 3-1 ball game. Back after this on the show. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now here's the Detroit catcher, Jake Rogers. The wind of the pitch. Close one, doesn't get the call. Ball one. Movement in the bullpen, Giovanni Gallegos, the closer of the staff, is throwing. Helsley warming up as well. The 1-0. He was late there, strike one.
I got a ball, one strike.
Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. That was blasted to the moon. It's 3-2.
Well, I'm sure there's a big grin on his face right now, Boog. He's probably had some of those that didn't stay fair, but off the bat, it looked like it was going to bend foul. Was able to keep it in there, tucked it nicely, and he gets the jog around the bases. Good for him.
Here's Oliver Marmol towards the mound, and we're going to see a pitching change here. That's it for Lance Lynn in this one, and we'll be back with their first arm out of the pen after a quick break. Giovanni Gallegos takes over on the mound.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Parker Meadows up now for the Tigers. Outfield playing pretty shallow.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
And a pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. And the right-hander deals.
Ball one.
0-2 fastball way out of the zone. I think he's trying to speed him up. Got to stay back. Off-speed's probably coming.
Left-hand hitter waits. Fights it off. He'll see another. Trying to close out a one-run lead. And the home team trying to pull it out. Slow ground ball to the right side. Goldie takes it to the bag, and that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
That's a huge defensive play in the late stages of the game. It might not be the most challenging we've seen today, but it needed to be made. That's helping your team.
Now the left fielder, Riley Green. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And the righty deals. And fouled off.
Pretty good pitch to take a pass at in a 1-0 count. Just not able to square it up.
in the air out towards right center. Newt Barr on the move. Drops into the glove. Two away now.
The first baseman, number 21.
So last chance for the Tigers. Now a chance for Mark Canna. One for two. Sliced hard but foul. Right side, hard hit. Throw to first, ball game. And the Cardinals hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Start of a new month is a great chance to hit the reset button. Whether you're coming in hot or cold, getting that win today is a great feeling to continue through the rest of the month.